I'm back. So here is the current Solo. Solo HD, I think it's called. Get that out of the way. So I couldn't find the white one. Maybe someone borrowed it and I can't find it. I don't remember where I put it. So this is the drenched in color black version I'm going to show you guys. I apologize for not being able to find the white one. And so there it is. The new Solo 2 is bigger. Can see that slightly. The air cushions are certainly much bigger. You can see that. So Solo 2 certainly is an upgrade from the original Solo design, even though this is the new drenched in color. Now, they did improve the sound on the drenched in color Solo HD, so I expect the new Solo 2 to be even better. Much better than when it was Monster in terms of sound quality and build quality, but in fact. So, you can see here, just a more comparison, just to show you guys the size comparison. So, as you can see here, new Solo 2 is a lot bigger if you look at the original Solo design. So I really like it. Alright, so now I am going to try them on for you. Oh, before I go, I mentioned the new cable design, which is the same as the new Studio. As you can see here, the Solo HD that's drenched in color has the old cable design with the old B logo. Focus on this thing. It's hard for the camera to focus, but anyway, there it is. That's the old design. And then the jack on the other side. The new design is far better. There it is. Now the old one says Beats on the jack itself. The new one does not, on this end at least. So that's it. So I'm gonna try them on and show you guys what they look like on me. Alright, now that you saw what came in the box and you got a close-up look at the headphones, it's time to see what it looks like on me. As you can see, I have here around my neck. It is very stylish. I really like the brilliant white color. It's certainly a lot brighter than the other Beats headphones, even though they are white as well. This is certainly more vibrant. Now, and the white cable is really nice. One concern that I have is that it getting dirty really quickly. So that's something that you want to keep in mind as well. The headphones shouldn't get dirty quickly because they are gloss white. So there's a coat of clear coat all over the headphones. But the cable is the only thing that I would be concerned about. Here it is again around the neck. I mean, this is certainly a lot more stylish than a lot of headphones on the market. A lot of people ask me on forums and over here on YouTube if the cushions get dirty quickly. They actually don't, to my surprise. You can also clean it with some little bit of soap and water on a damp cloth. You don't want to rinse this in water, of course. So a little bit of Murphy soap oil should be able to clean it off, or leather cleaner. Another thing I really like with the new Solo 2 is that the inside of the headband is also pure white. Unlike the Mixer or even the new Studio, the new Studio on the inside is gray. So this is all white, certainly very stylish.
I really like it. You know, they fit really well too. As you can see, it goes completely over my ears. Now, this is not around the ear like the studio is. This is still on ear, but it is very comfortable. The pads are very, very soft. They isolate outside noise much better than the original Solo XD. The original Solo XD rests right on your ears. I mean, it's a great fit, but this is certainly a lot more comfortable. You know, like I said, I was able to use it for a few weeks already, and I really like the way these sound. They really improved on the sound quality by a lot. The build quality as well, a very solid feeling. It folds in nicely. Certainly a premium product for $199. Sound quality compared to the original Solo XD or the Drenched in Color Solo XD, Beats really changed the sound of their Solo XD when they transitioned away from Monster. They certainly improved the sound quality and build quality by a lot, in my opinion. Even the Drenched in Color Solo XD, really cleaner sound, a lot more snappy, still has good bass, still goes very low in terms of bass quality wise. Really a much better product than it was originally. Now the Solo 2, this is a clear winner. The sound quality on this is phenomenal. Mid-range is very smooth, very natural sounding. There's not a hint of harshness to this headphone. Bass is very, it goes very low, still vibrates the eardrum a little bit. Not as much as the last version of the Drenched in Color, but still you are getting the signature beat sound. They did a phenomenal job cleaning up the sound, and now you can actually use this for a wide variety of sound music, not just rap and hip-hop or electronic dance music, but you know, all sorts of music, rock, pop. It really performed very well. I really like this headphone. I actually like it more than the new Vmota XS. The XS is a fabulous headphone, don't get me wrong, very durable, great sound quality, but I think the new Solo 2 sounds a little bit better. And it fits better on my ears too, it's a lot more comfortable. I urge you guys, check it out. The new Solo 2 is a fabulous product. I am certainly going to highly recommend this product to anyone who are interested in a cool looking headphone, well built, very comfortable, and easy to travel with as well. So check it out. You know, decide on which, the hardest part I think is to decide on which color to get. And if you guys want to see more colors, let me know in the comments. I'll see if I can get more of the other colors. So right now I have the white ones. So let me know in the comments. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. I'll put some more photos and stuff on social media for you guys. So you guys got the exclusive first look at it. Please share this video. It really helps me out a lot in getting manufacturer support. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys again in the next video. Bye-bye.